And it's not at all clear to me why there should be a distinction between those two zones with regard to recreation facilities. The other comment I would have is that I think that a health facility is, in fact, a recreation facility in today's world, and that there really should be no doubt that a health facility be included in the definition of recreation facilities as is proposed here. I thank you.
Thank you, sir. Any other comments from the public? Sir.
My name is John McDonald, and I live on Peebles Cove Road. And I also agree with what this gentleman has just comments he's made regarding the ordinance. And I also would like to just make my voice known that I support the project that's being put forward here. I think it's important. I think it's important to the youth of the community. I, too, send my son to South Portland High School to do weight training. Do that Tuesday and Thursday evenings. And I'd like to see it happen right here. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Further comments? Sir.
Mr. Chairman, members of the board, my name is Barry Zimmerman. I live at 4 Winding Way. I have helped Tom a little bit with this process, and recognizing what the chairman has said about that we're not to comment upon whether this is a good facility or a bad facility, I'll reserve my comments about what I think the town needs and focus just a little bit on what I think the recommendations in the comprehensive plan were for the town of Cape Elizabeth, which I think is pertinent to this discussion. And it seems to me, very briefly, that when you read the recommendations in the of the comprehensive plan, that it really encourages the expansion of this downtown central area that we have. And I think this facility would expand that area. It also seems to encourage these types of facilities that are going to benefit the residents of Cape Elizabeth, whether they be recreational or other types of facilities, but facilities that will specifically be of benefit that the city, that the citizens of Cape Elizabeth will use. And I think in that respect, this facility really does further the ends of the comprehensive plan. And for that reason, I think the board should seriously consider the change that we seek to make to the ordinance. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Any other comments? Sir. Sure. You're a member of the public.
My name is Tom Tinsman. I live at 24 Ocean Avenue. In reviewing the packet that's before you, the definition of a recreational facility seems fine to me. I think in terms of being a citizen of Cape Elizabeth and knowing what the needs are of the town's people, I think a fitness facility located in a business zone in Cape Elizabeth is something that the citizens of Cape Elizabeth do need. In reviewing other fitness centers that are located around Greater Portland, it is very obvious that Cape Elizabeth is the only town in Greater Portland that does not have such a facility. So it is not something that's a new concept. It's not something that's going to change our trends. It's something that's going to catch us up with other communities. My son has also participated in weight training programs. I have also participated. I've had to travel great distances to participate in these activities, and I think it's time that Cape Elizabeth have its own facility. Talking specifically about the requirements that we have here in the memorandum, the height restrictions of 35 feet I think are certainly adequate. I think that's something that's within the town plan right now, and certainly something that I think could be worked within. As far as the parking goes, one space per 250 square feet. I'm not an expert on parking, but I certainly would try to conform to whatever the town engineer says is adequate. In terms of requirements, at the end of the definition of a recreational facility, I think the site plan review does cover most of the items that are going to be of concern, and I'm not sure that we need to be concerned with setbacks and access and turnarounds and all those things. Those are addressed in a site plan review, and in looking over what the extensiveness is of the site plan review, I certainly think that all of those areas would be covered. I would like to push again for my request that this not be a conditional use. I think that going through the site plan review does give the town adequate time and requirements to look over a facility to see if that it does meet the requirements of the town. I realize that changing an ordinance to allow this type of facility in a BA zone would open it up to other areas of the town that have a BA zone. I can't see that that would be a detriment to the town. I can't see us offering too much health to the people of Cape Elizabeth. I think if it was a dangerous or hazardous type of facility that could be located next to a residential zone, I would say that that would probably be something that might have to be looked at a little bit tighter. This is a very clean industry. It is not something that emits any type of dangerous odors. There certainly will be have to have some access requirements and problems addressed when this does actually come through site plan review, but I'm very confident that we can work together and work those problems out. If a health facility were located in a BA zone elsewhere in Cape Elizabeth, I think that it too would have to meet its own site plan reviews based on all the requirements, and they are extensive when you go through the site plan review. So I would just like to move that we don't make it a conditional use, because that is not really accepting it as a use in town and could delay the process quite significantly and really duplicate a lot of the items that will be covered by the planning board. And I feel very confident working with the planning board that we could come up with a very good project for the town. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Any other questions from the public? Comments? Seeing none, I close the public hearing at this point, and I would draw back to the planning board at this point in time, and got a few things to consider here before we send this on. First of all, any general comments from the board on this issue? Mr. Emery.
On what basis was the one space per 250 determined? Was that from our engineer?
Yeah. Yes, it was based on the engineer, and he used their experience with existing facilities and also standards that have been developed over the years.
Someone would refresh my memory, whether a member of the audience or other planning board members. Is this facility not to be used as a area of assembly, for public assembly? I only raise that as an issue because in most school projects, the parking requirement for schools are determined upon that area that will accommodate the greatest public assembly, and typically that ends up being a gymnasium, and although gymnasiums tend to be open, the state requires it. We consider that they're filled with seats for something like a holiday season concert or something. Do you see, in your experience with health facilities, that you would have the largest floor area of your building occupied with chairs much in the same way we have here?
No, I would foresee that being what the schools would use their gyms for and continue to use those for.
Okay.
It's not clear to me. I will admit I haven't pored over the attorney's letter. Is he only recommending specific standards if we propose a conditional use review, or in either event? Is he saying that we should provide specific standards for site plan review for this specific use?
What the town attorney is recommending is that if you want to make it a conditional use, that you think about what your specific concerns are, what motivates you to make it a conditional use, and to specifically state those, as the existing conditional use standards do not specifically address this use. If you still feel there are concerns about this particular use, but you're willing to make it a permitted use, and you don't feel those concerns are specifically addressed in the site plan standards, then again, you may want to attach specific conditions. If you feel that you want to make it a permitted use and that any of your concerns could be adequately addressed by the site plan ordinance, the site plan regulations, then no additional requirements need be proposed.
I did raise the issue of conditional use review, but rather than being done at the planning board, be a simultaneous review, by the zoning board, be a simultaneous review by the planning board. And I used an example of the city of Portland, which does so for certain uses within residential areas. It's not my interest to bog an applicant down with a two-step process that in many ways does not provide much additional information. On the other hand, I don't know that I have a list of standards that I'm willing to offer up as those which I think are most necessary under site plan review, other than those which we already have. So at this point, I'm really saying is that getting back, I guess, to Mr. Tinsman's comments that it's not a dangerous or hazardous type of facility, I agree. That's correct, but it is a public facility and could tend to have some impact in certain areas in town that are unforeseeable. And all I'm saying is that if I'm sitting on this board, I will take some liberties in reviewing the mass of the building and the impact on parking and pedestrian circulation and those things, and be not arbitrary to outside of the ordinance, but I will be rigorous in review of that. And I think if I say it up front, that's a fair trade for dropping my concerns about conditional use.
Okay. Any other comments from the board? Mr. Edsel.
Mr. Chairman. I think we have to constantly focus on the issue that we're not dealing with, is there a need for a recreational facility, and that this is not one specific application. That we're looking, and I'm a little bit not totally confused, because I think we're dealing with, if I'm correct, recreation facility. I see it referred to as health facility in some areas, but recreational facility, which is already included in the Business B district. And one of the members of the public asked why, what the difference was in my understanding of the three types of business district, business district C is more office park, research facilities, industrial light manufacturing. B is business use, but not typically business use found in a village area, and business A being more village type retail businesses. I think the question is, as a board, is the recreational facility, as it's been defined, and basically, as far as I can see, one of the important things is that it doesn't include spectators. I think the legal advice to change the word fans to spectators is a good recommendation. But that's important. I think, going back to the workshop, the original intent, from my point of view, was to not overly regulate this use with a lot of requirements, in that it would come under the review of the planning board. Unfortunately, from legal opinion, unless we specifically designate what those guidelines are, and I, in the body of the letter, Legal counsel says that the applicant has to be able to answer the question, what facts must I present to gain the board's approval? Unless we make that real clear, then we don't have a lot to stand on if those requirements are not made up front. Again, looking to the comprehensive plan, the draft that I have, number one, the Village Center is not the only BA zone, is my understanding, but we have to consider either one or two other locations in town. The traffic safety is a major concern, according to the comprehensive plan, for the Village Center part of the BA district, anyway. And the idea of limiting commercial development to the currently business-zoned areas, which we seem to be complying with. It's a question of is this use appropriate for that zone, and if so, how do we define it? I would recommend that we follow our legal counsel voice to vote legal counsel's opinion with alternative two to make some of the necessary changes that he's requested.
Just to clarify, and you're suggesting that we make it a permitted use, or?
Yes.
Okay.
With reasonably specific requirements.
Okay. Ms. Kane.
My feeling is to go with it as a permitted use. I think that at the time the zoning ordinance was drafted, if a recreational facility of this type had been something that it is now in the late 80s, would probably have been included anyway. That's my feeling. With respect to our council's advice, I am, as always, caught on the double-edged sword of hamstringing ourselves indefinitely.